Hi to everyone. Leveling surveying. Hi students. So today we are going to see rise and fall method. So in the previous class we have seen the height of instrument method. So let us see our problem of example number 3. Okay. So first see the question here. The following staff readings were observed successfully with a level the instrument was shifted after the second and fifth readings. Okay, the readings were given are 0.675, 1.230, 0.750, 2.565, 2.225, 1.935, 1.835, 3.220. So these are the readings which are taken by the dummy level, and here the first staff reading was taken with the staff held on a benchmark of reduced level is 125.325 meters. Enter the readings in the level book form and find the reduced levels of all points by rise and fall method. Okay, and check the correctness of the reductions. So this is the arithmetical check we have to do. So now in this problem the levels were given. So first, how to identify which is backside and which is intermediate side and which is foreside? So you can see everyone have to observe and everyone have to study the question properly. In the question itself you will know the where is the backside and where is the intermediate side and where is the foreside. So this method of drawing the on the ground will be implemented to height of collimation method also. So let us see now in the diagram on the question, the instrument was shifted after the second and fifth readings. So here the second one will be the TP1 and the fifth reading will be the TP2. That means these two are the change points of stations. Okay, so you can see here whatever given here, the first one will be the back side. Okay, and others will be the intermediate sides or fourth side. So that is depending upon here. So coming to here, you can see in this diagram the first benchmark which was given here, that is RL is equal to 125.325. okay, so on the benchmark we have got the back reading is first one is 0.675. okay, that is from the first instrument. And the next you can see the whatever the reading which is there, that is 1.230, will be the foreside. Why? Because it is the change point. So wherever the change point comes here, you will be getting one foreside and backside. Okay, so the first one which is there, this is one is backside, and the 1.230 will be the foreside. So that is in between the instrument. Okay, and the next, so in between this foreside, so if we are changing the instrument station point on the other place on the ground, so from seeing from this instrument, this point which is FS will be the backside. So that will be the 0.750. okay, so in between you can see again here second point changing point is this one. Okay, so whenever you are getting the fifth reading, that you can see here from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so where is the reading you are getting, that is fifth reading is 2.225. okay, so in between which is the intermediate side we are having, that is 2.65. so 2.565 is nothing but intermediate side, and the last one which is there you can see that is known as foreside, that is 2.225. okay, so here you will be getting the turning point 1 and turning point 2. So wherever the turning point we are getting, again you will get the backside, that is known as 1.935. okay, so 1.935 which will be the backside, and you can see the last one which is there, this 3.200 will be the foreside. So in between we are getting a one point, that is 1.835 will be the intermediate side. Okay, so one backside and intermediate side there, and the last one will be the foreside. So like this way we have to draw the diagrams here. Okay, this is the one level station, second one and the third one. So three instruments were fixed on the ground. So this is the ground level. I have given the diagram. Okay, in this way we have to first draw the diagram. After that we have to label it in our table. So as per the diagram we can label very easily in that diagram. Okay, so the first one is nothing but station. So how many stations are there? First we have to count it. That is, first one is A, B, C, D, E, F. So write it in the table, A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, then we have to write as per the table, back side, intermediate side, fourth side, and here we will be getting, this is rise and fall method. You have to write rise and fall, and this is RL means reduced level, and remarks, and here there will be no height of instrument. Why? Because this method is rise and fall method. And first of all we have to know what is rise and what is fall. So rise means it is nothing but the ground level is increasing, that is nothing but in the positive way, and the fall means the ground level will be in the decreasing, so that is nothing but negative. Okay, remember, increasing and decreasing. So now let us calculate. So you mention first one, that is 0.65675, is nothing but back side, and the next one, the fourth side reading which is there 1.230, that you write in the fourth side, and which is there in the back side 0.75 in the back side, intermediate side 2.565, and here the fourth side will be the 2.225, and the back side will be the 1.935, and the intermediate side which is there 1.835, and the last one which is there 3.200, you write it in the fourth set. Okay, so now after doing this we have to do the rise and fall. How to get the rise and fall? Okay, so first you have to see, this is the formula we are having. Okay, so you have to write the reduction levels, the procedure of this everything. So you can see here, the first one which is there, procedure of reduction of levels, rise and fall, is that is backside on point A minus foreside on point B. So what is backside and what is foreside? You can see here. So this is the backside, 0.675 minus foreside, that is 1.230. So here you will be getting this one, 0.675 minus 1.230. You will get minus 0.355. So minus, if you are getting, that is fall. You have to write in the table 0.355. So where the negative box are there, that one you have to write 0.355. Okay, and the next we have to do another one, that is backside on point B minus IS on point C. So where is the backside on point B? Here you can see, this is the backside on point B, 0.750 minus, we have to do IS, 2.565. Then you will be getting the reading as minus 1.815. That we have to write in the table 1.815. Okay, then the next one we have to do, that is third one, IS on point C minus FS on point D. So IS on point C, which is nothing but, this is the IS, 2.565 minus FS, 2.225. You have to write this one, you will be getting 0.340. That, so here we are getting the positive, so we have to write it in the rise, 0.340. okay, then after, again what we are having, backside on point D. Okay, backside on point D minus intermediate side, that is on point E. You will be getting 1.935 minus 1.835, positive we are getting 0.100. that we have to write in the rise, 0.100. and the last one is there, that is nothing but intermediate side on point E minus FS on point F. Then you will be getting 1.835 minus 3.220 is equal to minus 1.385. so that one will be the, this one, last one, 1.835 minus 3.220, then you will be getting negative answer is 1.385. so totally we got now rise and fall readings. So now you do the next one. Finally we have to calculate now RLs. So how to calculate RLs? So this one is first one, 125.325 was given RL. So to get the these all other RLs, we have to do 125.325. okay, you can see here in the calculator, 125.325, okay, we have to do. So what is the symbol we have given? Minus 0.355. You will be getting answer as 124.7695. So we have to write overall 124.7770. Okay, you will be getting, once again see it, 125.325 minus 0.355. You will get 124.770. Okay, this is the RL on point B. And the next we have to write, so another one to get this 124.70 will be like this only, 124.770 minus, we have to do this one, which is there, minus 1.815, minus 1.815. Then you will be getting 122.955. That we have to write on point C. RL is 122.955. Then after completion of B and C, then we have to go for the RL of point D. Okay, so to get this RL of point D, we have to do again 122.955 plus 0.34. Then you will be getting 123.295. You will be getting the 123.295. Okay, then after the last one, you can see 123.295 plus 0.100. Then you will be getting 123.395. So by doing this one, 123.295, we will be getting the answer as 123.395. Okay, so after this, the last one is there, which one we have to do? Minus 123.395 minus 1.385. then you will be getting the answer as 123.395 minus 1.385. then you will be getting the answer is 122.010. so finally we got the all RLs. So after that, we have to do the total backside 3.36 and the total foreside 6.615 and the total rise 0.440 and the total fall 3.755. after doing this all, we have to do our, the as per the procedure, arithmetical check. This is our formula: sigma bs, sigma backside minus sigma fs is equal to sigma rise minus sigma fall is equal to last rl minus first rl. So what is the total we got? 3.36 the first one backside, and the fs is 6.675 is equal to sigma fall is 0.440 and the sigma fall is 3.755. okay, and is equal to last rl, which is last rl, this is 122.010 and the first rl is 124.325. so after getting this one, you will be getting the total as 3.315. okay, so we are getting in the negative symbol. Okay, in the negative symbol, hence check is okay. So the check is tallied. Here negative sign indicates there is not net fall of 3.315 meters from station A to station F. That is nothing but from station A to station F. So here from station A to station F, that means the ground will be decreasing from up to down. So this is a problem of a rise and fall method. Okay, in this way you have to do the problems. Okay, thank you, have a nice day.